How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. Today, we're going to be talking about the security of NordVPN. So before we begin, if you guys are interested in NordVPN, you can find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as a full-on review if you'd like to know the ins and outs of NordVPN in terms of privacy policy, speed, streaming, and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. So be sure to keep that in mind if you guys are interested. Now, getting into the security features of NordVPN, Nord does have a good variety of advanced options with, first of all, top-of-the-line protocols. We're talking about NordLynx, OpenVPN, OpenVPN TCP for the most part. Now, if you're looking for extra security, you could go for OpenVPN UDP, OpenVPN TCP, or TCP for even more security, but 9 times out of 10, 99.99% of the times, all you need is NordLynx, and that will be the best protocol you can get. Now, of course, you also have Cybersec, which will block ads and malicious adware or malware for that matter. It may not be as good as a dedicated antivirus software, but it still does the job. You also have a kill switch, an internet kill switch, which will disable, of course, your internet connection when the VPN disconnects unexpectedly. And you also have the option of the app kill switch, which you don't see much in too many VPNs, which will disconnect or actually will close selected applications rather than closing your entire connection or terminating your entire connection. And with regards to encryption, by the way, NordVPN uses AES-256 GCM encryption with a 4096-bit DH key. And of course, you have the option of split tunneling, which will let you decide which apps are included or exempt from the VPN tunnel. Not just that, if you go to the... actually, we're going to have to switch to OpenVPN in order to get access to a double VPN and dedicated IP. So double VPN will route your connection through two servers rather than one to give you just extra security, as you can tell here. So if I pick Netherlands, you'll notice that I have a bunch of combinations here. Of course, you also have dedicated IP if that's something you're interested in. A lot of other VPNs will charge for that, but you can get your own personalized dedicated IP, but you still get the option here to get just specific servers with the same IP every single time. So that's pretty cool. Onion over VPN is a great security tool that will give you access to the dark web without having to use the Tor browser. Peer-to-peer will support peer-to-peer activities such as torrenting, which can also be very useful. Of course, you've got DNS leak protection and obfuscation tools. So if we go to advanced here, though, for obfuscation, you don't really need to use it unless the regular servers are not working. And by the way, obfuscation will only work with OpenVPN TCP. So if I go to OpenVPN TCP here, I'll be able to access or turn on obfuscated servers. But notice, you'll notice that it will isolate the obfuscation servers and I won't be able to use anything else. But you can, of course, use TCP without obfuscation if that's something you would like to also do. But overall, as I said earlier, you don't really need much more than NordLynx. It is the greatest protocol you can ever use. And as I stated earlier, you won't need obfuscation unless you're living in a country with heavy restrictions like China and you're having trouble accessing the regular servers, or a country where VPN usage may be banned, since obfuscation will essentially obfuscate your browsing data and make your browsing look like any other normal data so that even your ISP won't be able to tell that you're using a VPN. It will also help you, of course, bypass the Great Firewall of China. And you know, another cool feature, of course, is the custom DNS. This is easy. This is an easy way to change your DNS. So if that's something you're interested in, you can definitely do that. And not just that, of course, NordVPN uses RAM disks rather than hard drives so that there's no actual physical drive to store data in, so that whatever minimal data is stored on the RAM servers will be deleted within every machine reboot. So that is very useful. And that's pretty much it, really. When it comes to security, Nord is really just super solid. It's as solid as it gets. And you do get these special or extra features, which is double VPN and, you know, on top of the 256-bit encryption, as well as the 4096 key and double VPN. That's about as much security as you can get with a VPN. You know, NordVPN is very, very useful when it comes to just, you know, streaming services, securing your data, using it for peer-to-peer activity, or onion over VPN. You've got many uses for NordVPN. It's packed with features and it's just, you know, it's got a very visually appealing UI. So whether you're a beginner or an advanced user, whatever you're looking out of NordVPN, you'll find something to like. Now, of course, if you guys are interested in learning more about NordVPN, you will find a full review down below. I'll give you more of an in-depth look into the advantages and disadvantages of the VPN. And you'll also find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below if you guys are interested. So feel free to take advantage of those while they last. So that'll be it for this video. If you guys enjoyed it, feel free to like the video and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and would like to see more. And thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a wonderful day.